Mullen.
Coming up on this episode of Windy City Poker Championship, aggression is the key to winning at poker.
Mullen.
And these Chicago guys are getting more and more assertive as players drop out of the final table. Plus, later on in the show, Kirk sits down with two Chicago pros to break down and analyze hands previously seen on the Windy City Poker Championship in hopes to help you at home become a better player. All that and so much more here on Windy City Poker Championship.
I'm all in.
See, you're all in. I call.
Hello, Chicagoland. I'm Michael Lapidus, and we're here at Windy City Poker Championship, and this is Kirk Fala.
We're back here at Cactus Bar and Grill, downtown Chicago, for the conclusion of the final table at the Windy City Poker Championship. Let's take a look at the highlights from last show.
Previously on Windy City Poker Championship.
The show began with the players being a bit intimidated by poker professional TJ Cloutier.
20,000.
Gold.
Can't take on a pro in my first hand.
Then as they got more comfortable being under the lights and on camera, the action at the table began to heat up.
Look at 12.
Alan Wabey with Queen 10 offsuit puts in a raise to try to isolate the short stack Ben Marcello, who's pot committed in this hand. However, Brian White, who was in the big blind, wakes up with pocket eights and has a tough choice to make.
I'm all in too.
He ended up pushing all in and was called right away by Alan, who takes the lead on the turn.
Queen, now the queen's the boss.
Allen would knock out two players in this hand, sending Ben home in seventh and Brian home in sixth. Then on the very next hand, Todd Murray sizes up TJ Cloutier's chip stack and with his ace-queen offsuit goes all in to put TJ to the test.
I'm all in.
All right, I call. I can't throw it away for this.
Now pre-flop, TJ had a chance with suited King Jack, but as soon as the flop came, Todd could finally relax as he was about to knock out a poker legend.
How do you like his hand now, boys? Nice play with you guys.
So we're down to four players here at the final table. In position number one is Todd Murray, who finished second in our last event and is hoping to take the next step up and become a Windy City Poker champion. He is currently in first place with 232,000 in chips. In position number two is Gino Francone. Gino is second in chips with 135,000. To Gino's left is Alan Wabey with 115,000 in chips. And the short stack is Walter Bustos with 41,000 in chips. Now the table and Walter's wife are hoping he gets knocked out soon so he can go home for dinner.
Sure was an exciting first show, Michael. We're looking for an exciting conclusion here at the Windy City Poker Championship.
Well, it's coming close to 4th of July. Hopefully we see some fireworks here at this final table.
Blinds are at 6 and 12,000 with a 1,000 chip ante. Gino's going to be first to act with 4-2 off suit. He's in the cutoff position. He's going to fold. Allen's on the button, 10-2 off suit. He folds as well and gets out of the way.
Walter's in the small blind with 5-3 off suit.
Oh.
He's just going to limp in.
All in.
And this is what's wrong with limping in the small blind sometimes, because the big blind's got a suited ace. Todd's going to go all in, put the short stack to the test. Michael, Walter should have folded his cards in the first place.
I think that's a cruel bet, Kirk.
Well, Todd's got more than six times the chips that Walter does right now, so if Walter woke up with the hand, it really wouldn't affect Todd that much. So next time, Walter, short stack, fold your 5-3.
Tonight I've played okay. I'm pretty patient, just got lucky on a... Got lucky on one hand early on, and then pretty much just kind of tried to pick off some short stacks along the way.
Well, Todd sure is running away with the chip lead count here. He has over 247,000 chips. Allen's going to be first to act. He has Queen 6 off suit. He's going to fold.
Todd's in the small blind with 9-7 off suit. He's going to call. Gino's going to check his option from the big blind, and we're going to see a flop.
Here comes the flop. Queen 10-9.
Rainbow flop. However, Todd does catch bottom pair. He's going to lead out with a bet of 16,000, and Gino's going to laugh and get rid of his cards because he caught absolutely none of that with the 7-5.
There goes the chip leader bully.
Walter's getting blinded out here at the final table, Michael.
Well, it's time for him to act. Walter's looking down at ace eight offsuit. He's going to go all in.
Well, Michael, he's going to be all in within the next three hands, probably. You look down, you see an ace. It's probably the best opportunity for you to push your chips in the middle.
Todd's on the button. He has 7-3 offsuit. He's going to fold.
I don't have to look. Good luck.
Alan, 10-3 offsuit.
What do I got to beat?
He's going to call even without looking.
He's already got 12,000 in the pot, Michael. It's another 14 to try to knock a player out. So you're gonna call with any two random cards here.
I just need one three.
Flop comes 2-6-7.
No help to Alan. Walter is still in the lead right now with his ace high. Alan needs a 10 or a 3 to take down this pot. Otherwise, Walter's gonna double up. And there you go. Walter picked a good time to push all in right there. He's gonna double up through Alan and win this pot of 62,000.
Good time to go all in, Walter.
I'm very nervous, you know, TV. I think the cameras add extra pressure on you. I think I've been playing pretty good. I'm pretty tight, aggressive, you know, when I need to be. The final table, I think I have to be a little bit more aggressive because the blinds are so big that my stack is starting to dwindle. So I'm definitely gonna have to try and be a little bit more aggressive.
We'll be right back with more Windy City Poker Championship, but before we go, I had a chance to talk to WPT Bootcamp's Crispin Laser and ask him for some expert advice on the game of poker.
The more you play the game, the more you realize there are just so many factors that go into every decision that you make at a poker table. The first thing we tell people at the course is that the object of poker is to make correct decisions. A lot of people think, oh, the object of poker is to make money and win pots. But if you think about the game in terms of that the object of poker is to make correct decisions, and then all the factors that go into making those decisions, and people think, oh, it's just about the cards I'm dealt, but it's about so much more than that. It's about what position you're in and what your chip stack is and who your opponents are, and looking for correct situations to identify the exact time to make a move with your chips, etc. So there are so many factors that go into making every decision at the poker table, and we're just trying to arm you with every piece of information that we can so that you can make the correct decision in the right situation.
Aztec Audio, Video, and Communications is your one-stop shop for all of your audio and video needs. They specialize in design and installation for both commercial and residential audio-video systems. They offer full design services from theater-style decor to full-room build-outs. With complete turnkey solutions to all of your audio and video needs, their licensed, insured, and bonded contractors will do all the work needed so that you can relax and enjoy your new multimedia room. So call them right now at 773-502-8383. You can also check them out online and browse their interactive website at aztecav.com. That's aztecav.com.
Making sure your brakes are working properly is very important. We can fix that. If you need brakes, bring your car to the experts. Call 773-238-0606. Brock's Auto Center, your trustworthy service center for the last 25 years. Mention this ad and receive a lube oil and filter change for $21.95. At Brock's, we can fix that.
If you'd like to play in a future televised Windy City Poker Championship, here's a schedule of our future productions. But if TV isn't your thing, you should check out the non-televised tournaments being offered by Main Event Charity Games. So log on today and sign up at maineventcharitygames.com. Seats fill up very fast. For more information, you can email us. Our email address is info@windycitypokerchampionship.com.
Why shop at a franchise? Break that chain for quality service at your local family-run grocer. Come to Bizio's Fresh Market for organic produce, daily delivered fish, and the best hormone-free Angus beef around. Browse aisle after aisle. Find over 200 selections of wine, international products, daily prepared foods, and much more. Located at Volmer Road and Governor's Highway, Bizio's Fresh Market can even cater your next event. For savings and specials, biziosmarket.com.
Las Vegas casinos have used fully automatic card shufflers for years, ensuring fairness and increasing profits from every table. Now, ShuffleTech presents the first fully automatic shuffler available for tournaments and private games. ShuffleTech uses patent-pending technology approved for use in casinos. A standard casino dealer's combination takes less than 35 seconds. Speed play in your game, increase your hands per hour, and guarantee fairness for all of your players. ShuffleTech. Quality games begin here.